Part 2. We describe two equations, interaction of allelic genes and interaction of non-allelic genes. Gene interaction is interaction between different genes residing within the same genome in the production of a particular phenotype. These interactions can produce variations from the classical genetic ratios. There are two types of such interaction, interaction of allelic genes and interaction of non-allelic genes. Question number 4. Interaction of allelic genes. Allele or allelomorph allelic gene is one of a series of possible alternative forms of a given gene. Alleles are different forms of a gene. If more than two alleles have been identified in a population, they are called multiple alleles. Allelic genes are located at the same loci of homologous chromosomes. They determine particular forms of a character. In our picture, we can find that big A and small a are allelic genes. Big B and small b, big D and small d also are allelic genes. There are four types of interaction of allelic genes. The first, complete dominance. The heterozygote BK-a possesses the same phenotype as the homozygote BK-a. Dominant allele inhibits recessive allele. We can use such formula. Big A inhibits the recessive gene small a. Dominant homozygote has the same phenotype as heterozygote, in contrast to recessive homozygote. Red color of a flower, red color, and white flower. The result of the cross of two heterozygotes is the 3-to-1 ratio. The second, incomplete dominance, or partial dominance, semi-dominance. The heterozygote BK-a has a phenotype that is intermediate between the homozygous dominant and the recessive forms. In our picture, we can find that homozygous organisms, big R, big R, have red flowers, homozygous recessive organisms have white flowers, but heterozygotes have intermediate color, pink flowers. A dominant phenotype is not fully expressed in an organism carrying a dominant and recessive allele. We can use such formula. BK-BK more than BK-a and more than a. The offspring in the F2 generation appears in the ratio 1:2:1. The same ratio as for genotypes ratio. The third, co-dominance. Both alleles of a pair are fully expressed in the heterozygote. The heterozygote simultaneously expresses traits of both homozygotes. For example, the human being of AB blood group is showing the phenotypic effect of both IA and IB codominant genes, which results in the production of A and B antigens on red blood cells. The offspring in the F2 generation appears in the ratio 1:2:1. The fourth, overdominance, is a phenomenon of heterozygotes having a more extreme phenotype than either homozygote. The heterozygote BK-a is more fit than BK-BK or a individuals. It is monohybrid heterasis. Heterasis is the increase in size, yield, and performance found in some hybrid plants and animals, especially if the parents are from inbred stocks, also known as hybrid Wiege. And we can find the formula that explains this phenomenon. The offspring in the F2 generation appears in the ratio 1:2:1. The fifth, interallelic complementation, also known as allelic complementation, intragenic complementation, is a type of interaction between two different mutant alleles coding for subunits of a multimeric protein, which causes the reconstruction in the cytoplasm of a functional protein from the inactive products of the two alleles. The mixed protein, heteromultimer, may exhibit more activity, positive complementation, or less activity, negative complementation, than the homomultimer. It was shown for alkaline phosphatase of E. coli that is a dimer made up of two identical protein subunits. Question number 5. Interaction of non-allelic genes. Non-allelic genes are genes at different loci. They can determine both different characters, for example, flower color and seed color, and particular forms of a character, exemplificata, human height. In our picture, we can say that genes big A and big B are non-allelic genes because they are located on different chromosomes. Genes big B and small d, big B and big D also are non-allelic genes because they are located at different loci of the same chromosome. There are 3 types of interaction of non-allelic genes. The first, complementation. In zebra parakeet, Melopsittacus undulatus, blue and yellow plumage are dominant over white plumage. Let's examine how blue plumage relates to yellow plumage. After crossing of blue and yellow homozygotes, all the F1 generation have green color plumage. When the F1 are intercrossed, F2 progeny are produced in a ratio of 9 green to 3 blue to 3 yellow to 1 white. We cannot explain the 9-3-3-1 ratio by using one gene. Hence, 2 non-allelic genes determine this trait. The gene big A, dominant gene, is an allele for blue pigment. Big B is an allele for yellow pigment. If an organism has recessive allele small a and recessive allele small b, no pigments are synthesized. Hence, an organism small a, small a, small b, small b will be white organism. Big A homozygous or heterozygous small b will have blue plumage. Small a, big b or big b, small b will have yellow plumage. But when two dominant genes are present in one organism, this organism will have new color, green plumage. Hence, two dominant alleles complement one another. Both complementary genes are required for the expression of some trait. It is complementary genes determine a novel phenotype. Let's consider recessive mutations that causes deafness in humans. Deaf persons often choose to have children with another deaf person. It would be expected that if two deaf persons were homozygous for the same recessive gene, small a crosses with small a, all of their children would be similarly affected, small a, deaf persons. But families have been described in which all the children born to parents deaf due to autosomal recessive genes have had perfectly normal hearing. The explanation for this must be that the parents were homozygous for mutant alleles at different loci, BK, BK, small b, deaf persons, and small a, big b, another deaf person. Non-allelic genes BK and big b determine normal hearing. The dominant allele big A controls normal development of acoustic nerve, and the allele big B codes for normal development of cochlea. Hence, an organism with acoustic nerve only is deaf. Organism with cochlea only is deaf. The organism with both dominant alleles, big A and big B together, is normal. Pay attention to the cross to the right. Dihybrid normal person, another dihybrid normal person. We can find the ratio in offspring, 9 of 16, two dominant genes together, 3 of 16, dominant gene B is present only, 3 of 16, dominant gene A and small b, 1 of 16, recessive homozygous person. 3 of 16 plus 3 of 16 plus 1 of 16, it means 7 of 16 persons will be deaf, only 9 of 16 will be normal. The phenotypic ratio is 9 to 7. The second type of interaction of non-allelic genes is epistasis. Epistasis is a situation in which one gene masks the expression of another gene. For example, the recessive gene Epteris in Drosophila produces wingless homozygotes. In such individuals, any other gene affecting wing morphology, like curled wings, will have its action masked. The Epteris gene is said to be epistatic to the gene curled wings which is hypostatic to the Apteryx gene. We can compare these two flies on pictures. Apteryx mutant fly to the right, fly with curled wings. Hence, this is an example of recessive epistasis. If an organism possesses genes a, this organism will have no wings at all. A gene for curled wings does not work. Pay attention to the scheme of cross to the right. Dominant homozygous fly with curled wings crosses with Apteryx fly. F1 generation dihybrids have curled wings because gene big A allows gene B to work. In the F2 generation, we can find 9 of 16 flies with curled wings, 3 of 16 with normal wings, and 3 of 16 plus 1 of 16, 4 of 16 Apteryx flies. In F2 generation, we can find the ratio 9 to 3 to 4. Dominant epistasis. It means that dominant gene masks the expression of another gene. Two genes determine fruit color in summer squash, Cucurbita pepo. The dominant allele big W inhibits pigment production. Another gene, Y, determines color of squash. Then genotype big W, big yellow or small yellow, produces white squash, whereas small W, allows pigment and results in colored squash. The second locus, Y, determines the type of pigment produced in the squash, with yellow, big Y, dominant over green, small y. This locus is expressed only in small w plants, which lack the dominant inhibitory allele, big W. Pay attention to the picture to the left. Big W gene is present, and squash has white color. Small y, pigment can be produced. Big Y, our squash has yellow color. Small y, two recessive alleles, our squash is green. Now we can find the result of crosses. Dominant homozygote, big W, big Y, has white color. And recessive homozygote, small w, small y, that has green color. In F1 generation, all dihybrids have white color, because big W is epistatic gene. In the F2 generation, we obtain progeny in a ratio 12 to 3 to 1. 12 of 16 white squash, 3 of 16 yellow squash, 1 of 16 green squash. The third type of interaction of non-allelic genes is polymery. Polymery describes such phenomenon: the working together of multiple genes to produce a single effect. Many traits display a range of variation, a large number of possible phenotypes. For example, length of the cone ears, milk production, many human traits such as height, weight, skin color, running speed, IQ, and many human diseases. Such traits are not easily distinguished and are called quantitative or continuous characteristics. They are controlled by many genes and are called polygenic traits or polygenic characteristics. Genes that control quantitative characters are called polygenes, multiple factors, or polymeric genes. Suppose that two pairs of genes, big A and small a, big B and small b, are responsible for ear length. Big A and big B are responsible for long ears, small a and small b for short ears. Big A, big A, big B, big B represents the genotype of the longest ear of cone, the first ear on the picture. And small a, small a, small b, small b represents the genotype of the shortest ears of cone. A cross between dominant homozygous and recessive homozygous parents results in F1 offspring, which are big a, big b, small b, diheterozygotes. They have intermediate lengths. If these F1 organisms are interbred, A broad range of genotypes and phenotypes is produced in the F2 offspring. The 1 to 4 to 6 to 4 to 1 ratio of phenotypes appears. We can find the explanation in our picture to the right. Two dihybrid organisms are crossed. Four different gametes are produced by each dihybrid. In the Punnett square, we can find one organism with longest ears, big A, big A, big B, big B. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four organisms have three dominant alleles and one recessive allele. They have long ears. Four organisms have two dominant and two recessive alleles, big A, small a, big B, small b. Or another variant, small a, big B, big B. Or another variant, big A, small b, small b. Six boxes have medium ears. If an organism has one dominant allele and three recessive alleles, such organism has short ears. Small a, big B, small b. Small a, big B, small b. And big A, small b, small b. Big A, small b, small b. Four variants. And one of 16 has shortest ears. Double recessive homozygous organism. 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Such ratio appears. Characteristics can be divided into two groups. Qualitative or discontinuous characteristics and another type, quantitative, continuous characteristics. What can you say about qualitative characteristics? They exhibit only a few easily distinguished discrete phenotypes. The relationship between genes and qualitative traits is very clear. Red flowers, white flowers. Right-handed person, left-handed person. Blood type A or blood type B. Quantitative or continuous characteristics display a large number of possible phenotypes that are not easily distinguished. All phenotypes must be described by a quantitative measurement. Unlike qualitative traits, the inheritance of quantitative traits, polygenic inheritance, is difficult to understand.